Good evening. I would like to call this Thursday, September 29th, 2022, receivers meeting with the public to order. If we can all stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the United States of America, to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Before we start tonight's meeting, as many of you are aware, Chester Upland School District lost one of our coaches who had a stellar record here in the basketball community. And we want to just take a moment to have a moment of silence for Coach Larry L. Yalberry Sr. If we can just take a moment of silence for Coach Yalberry. The district will most certainly be doing something to honor Mr. Yalberry in the very near future. More information will come. All right, we will get started tonight with our superintendent's report, Dr. Parkinson.
All right. Good evening, Receiver Nichols, and thank you. Good evening, Madam Board President, Board of Directors, Student Board Representatives. Good evening. Good evening to the audience out there, cabinet members. Before I start with my board report, there were a few questions from last week's meeting that I just wanted to follow up on. We had a question about Justice Works attendance, and as of September 8th, we had 23 students who was attending that program. We had a few questions about overall attendance in school, the number of students who were attending our high school, middle school. So at Chester High School, we have 901 total students. Chester Upland School of the Arts, CUSA, there are 429 students. STEM Academy at Showalter, there are 490 students presently enrolled. At Main Street Elementary, there are 309 students enrolled. At Stetzer Elementary, we have 248 students enrolled. Toby Farms Intermediate School, we have 340 total students enrolled. In our Digital Learning Academy, we have 101 students enrolled. And at our Edgemont Scholars Academy, we have a total of 415 students enrolled for a total of 3,233 students currently in the Chester Upland School District. Attendance numbers for Chester High School are 86%. CUSA, Chester Upland School of the Arts, is 89%. STEM at Showalter is 91%. Main Street Elementary attendance thus far is 85%. Stetzer Elementary is 88%. Toby Farms Intermediate School is 68%, Digital Academy is 82%, and our Edgemont Scholars Academy is at 89% in total attendance. Those were to address some of the questions that we had during our last our committee of the whole meeting. We completed our first full month of school, so we have finally worked with Pless and her team last week with that, but I want to once again this week, just recognize the HR team and just really thank them for all of their hard work over the summer and leading up to the start of the school year. We also held the district-wide bell ringing ceremony at each school, which marked the first day of school. So I want to say thank you to all of the schools who did a great job with this, all of the community members who came out in attendance. I feel that there's a competition brewing. I heard Toby Farms set things off with some line dancing, and they had a party out there. So I'm sure next year, you know, they will be outdone, I'm sure, because the other principals heard about that. So again, it was a great day, a great opening day for our students in the Chester Upland School District. As you all are aware, we spoke to the incident that took place at Chester High School on Thursday, September the 1st. We had a student-wide meeting that had a number of school counselors, community social workers, our district social workers, The entire administrative team went to support that during that, the next day, to focus on addressing the trauma that our students endured during that incident. We also had a community meeting that evening for the parents, all the stakeholders, to talk about what we want to do to reduce violence and just actually just react, how we're going to react and respond to incidents of significance that take place in our school community. We want to make sure that everyone knows these behaviors are normal, and we're going to do everything we can to provide support to our students who we truly love and care about. So there will be more to come. As I stated, at the conclusion of that meeting that evening with the stakeholders, we will have a follow-up meeting that has been scheduled, and I will make sure that that is communicated and put on the calendar for everyone to see, but there will be a follow-up meeting to that initial meeting with the community. I want to share some exciting news. Subaru of America and the Philadelphia Union adopted Stetzer Elementary School. It's a big deal, big day for the students in Stetzer Elementary as well as the teachers. If you all didn't hear, the teachers received $500 each to do whatever they needed for their students in Stetzer Elementary. So we thought that was the big surprise. And then they shared that Dr. Green had a wish list that she created. On that wish list was a 3D printer, it was a poster maker. So they received a poster maker. They also received gym equipment, balls, soccer balls, baseballs. You know, they just received a ton of gym equipment. They needed some gym equipment that was on the wish list, so that was granted. So when you thought that was all that was happening, they came out with another trick and said, we're going to give you $5,000, Dr. Green, to do whatever you need for your students and teachers. Right, so man. Another $5,000. And the Philadelphia Union, what a great day that was. So great time. Also wanted to make you aware that the Chester High School sports teams was recognized as they received the PIAA District 1 21-22 Sportsmanship Award, which is a big deal. To receive that award is truly challenging. You're graded on a number of things, obviously sportsmanship, how do you treat the officials, how do the student section perform, how do they behave. You're rated on a number of things. So for Chester High School to win that, that's a huge deal. I can tell you that's always one of my goals when I was a building principal. It was something that I tasked the athletic director to do. It was like, if we win anything, I said, I don't care how many games we win, this is the award that I want to win because it speaks to the character of our students. So the our Chester High School athletics program was recognized for the 2021-22 Sportsmanship Award, which again is a big deal. And congratulations to Coach Bell, Mr. Bell, and Mr. Brown, and most importantly, all the student athletes and students in the Chester Upland School District who made that possible. And that banner will be displayed in the gymnasium once we get it hung up there, but we will display that. Back to school nights took place in all of our schools over the first 3 weeks in September. I just want to say thank you to the parents for coming out and being engaged with the building principals as well as the teachers. And we're going to encourage you and ask you to please stay engaged and please continue to support your children throughout the school year with all the events that will be taking place. Just want to make you all aware that we're working to continue with the transparency and keep you all connected within the school district. The past few Thursdays, I've been doing what's called a Thursday Thoughts, a little segment on our TV station and also on our YouTube channel. So during that, the Thursday Thoughts is a video of me just about a minute or two. Someone told me I was on there too long the first time. So starting out 3 minutes, I cut it down to a minute. So just providing you with some great information about all the good things that are taking place in the district. And then that takes place every other Thursday. And then the Thursdays in between, we have what's called the Clipper Connection, which is our e-newsletter that's going out. So again, please be on the lookout. If you're not receiving the e-newsletter, just obviously shoot an email to me to let me know. But you can actually find that on the district website as well. There is a link connected to the e-newsletter as well as the Thursday Thought video. And just a quick tax collection update. The deadline for the homestead taxes count has been extended to December the 31st, 2022. If you have any questions, please view the website. Ms. Mosley did a fantastic video outlining the process. So again, please visit our website for that. And just a reminder, homecoming will be taking place on October the 22nd, where our Clippers will be taking on Chichester. That game begins at 11 o'clock, so we're hoping to see everyone out there for that event. Understand that we have a big party before and after the football game, but I'm asking everyone to come into the stadium to support the Clippers. off to another great start. They've outscored their opponents 300 and some points that I can't even count. They've just been on a tear right now. So, you know, I definitely want to congratulate them for the great start. And want to give a quick shout out and a thank you to Mr. Bell. We are all aware of the tragedy that took place at Roxborough High School yesterday with the football players. Coach Bell took the team captains down there to provide the building principal at Roxborough with some flowers and a card. And, you know, she was extremely emotional upon their arrival. So I just want to thank them for recognizing, you know, the communities that experienced trauma. And Coach Bell was there to do that. So again, thank you for that. Without further ado, we have a presentation from Toby Farms. So we have Mr. Popley, Ms. Godfrey, who will speak, and after them, you'll hear from our student board rep. So, Mr. Popley.
Okay, before you come, Mr. Popley, this Dr. Parks, and the extension for real estate taxes is not just for homestead, it's for all taxpayers. The discount period was extended for all taxpayers to 12/31. And homecoming, just to, you know, I have to say this, they didn't pay me to say this, but we have to be very responsible. I'm now talking to our alum. You know, this is school property, so there are things that are not permitted onto school property. But more information will come about that as well. Be responsible.
That's right. Fair to say. That's very fair. All right, stop. It's free.
Good afternoon, good evening to all.
Good evening.
Thank you, Mr. Nichols, Dr. Parkinson, all board members. As you all know, Dr. Parkinson talked about what we want to focus on in the first 30 days of school. One of the things you know about me, we talk about transparency. My door is always open. And I'm always encouraging partnerships, people to come into the school, and just to get an idea of what it is we're doing at Toby. One of the things I always focus on, when you come in, I want to ask a question. What do you see, what do you feel, and what do you hear? Because in an educational environment, you should see students collaborating, you should see group talk, you should see chatter, not chaos, but you should see chatter and see connections being made and all the students having a great time with their academics. So our presentation tonight is going to be more about the students. I don't want to sit here and take up all your time because I know we can talk about Toby Farms all day if you're going to sit here and listen to me. You have enough time. I'll do it. But everything that we do tonight and everything that you see is all student-centered. All of our students had a hand in the production of the videos that you will see. And also, as a gift to all the board members, you will receive a t-shirt that was designed by our life skills student. And it says, for the betterment of our children, hashtag Toby Nation. So you are now all a part of Toby Nation. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yeah, so I'm
Jennifer
Bell. We have a couple videos to start, and as Mr. Bobby said, the students scripted them, they shot them themselves with our video cameras, and then they really produced them in our multimedia exploration class. And this is a class that we added last year with a teacher who came out of the workforce from a production studio and decided he wanted more of a 9-to-5. So he has really worked hard. When I say the second day of school, I looked out and the kids are outside with video cameras, so they just jumped right in. So it's wonderful that they could get to this point already this school year. So we have a couple videos to start, we'll talk a little bit, and then we'll end it with a student video.
All right.
So again, again, our students really designed the videos, they picked the music, they put it all together. And what was amazing is, this kid standing there with their iPad, you know, kind of directing each other and talking, but even for the kids to get up in front of the camera and speak. I mean, if you've been in a classroom, you know sometimes they don't like to speak in front of each other, let alone on a camera. And probably at least 3 or 4 of those students in the video were brand new to Toby Farms. So it was really great to see them really including the new students and jumping right in and talking about what Toby means to them. The next two videos are students reflecting on our Toby mantra.
Hello, my name is Adam Salem. Today I would like to talk about what the Toby mantra means to me. The Toby mantra means many things to me, but the main meaning that came to me immediately was the words, I am only one, but I am one. This tells me that even though you are one person, you still are the one who can change things about the world. The next line confirms this to me. I cannot do everything, but I can do something. This adds more evidence to the meaning I got, because it's saying, you can't do all things, but being able to do something that you are good at is what you are. And I will not let what I cannot do interfere with what I can do. This line tells me that you shouldn't let what you can't do hold you back from what you can do. This nice message is what Toby mantra means to me.
My name is Cheyenne King. I am in the 7th grade, and this is what the Toby mantra means to me. I am only one, but I am one. I cannot do everything, but I can do something. And I will not let what I cannot do interfere with what I can do. Hashtag Toby Strong. What this means to me is that even though I'm one person, you don't need to do everything. To me, that sticks out because something is enough. You don't need to feel pressure to do everything because something is really better than nothing. My name is Harry King.
So this year at Toby Farms, we really felt like we were, you know, last year we were rocking and rolling, we were back from the pandemic, we were ready to go. But this year we wanted to make a couple changes. So we were able to shift our hours from 8:15 to 3:15, which has really helped with students being able to be home in time to help care for younger siblings. We have not seen an increase in tardies, so that is great. We have new middle school schedules for students, and what that means is in the past at Toby Farms, students traveled in a cohort. So if I was in your homeroom, we went to all of our classes together. It was a very elementary model. We have shifted, and we were able to use PSSA and Imagine Learning data from last year to level our math and English classes. The students now have a double English block with the same teacher, so they're able to really dive in and get almost 2 full hours of English a day on their level because the classes are leveled, and math is really able to meet the needs of the students, whether they're high or low, and the way the schedule is designed has allowed special ed teachers to push into those lower level English and math classes to meet the needs of the students on their caseload. This has made a huge difference in our culture, in that we are now treating the children as young adults, and then we're able to turn around and expect that from them. So in the past, if we were walking kids to lunch, the kids are looking at us like, you walked me to lunch, then you want me to act like I'm in 8th grade. So now we really were able to have the conversation. We're giving you the responsibility. And then in turn, we need that behavior back. And when I say that the students have absolutely stepped up, it has been amazing, absolutely amazing to watch the students grow and hold each other accountable and hold themselves accountable for where I am and when I'm supposed to be there. So that has been absolutely really transformed in our building. We're using our intervention time to use iReady. We're also incorporating corrective reading. So we screen students based on PSSA scores to pick out the 36 students in our building who will really benefit from that extra reading time. And they are meeting with a special education teacher, even if they're not a special education student, during our intervention block to really get that missing reading piece. And this year we've been able to add music and Spanish classes as special, so students see the music teacher and the Spanish teacher once a week. And that's been really fun to have something to kind of loosen up and have a great time in class. So they're really enjoying that. And the best thing is we are fully staffed. And this is our group of amazing brand new Chester Upland employees. We had a couple people join us from other schools, but these are all brand new to us. And I don't know where Dr. Plus is or where she found them, but we need to go back to that place and get more of them because they are amazing. 3 of them are math teachers. We had a completely empty math department, and they're certified, and they're fabulous. So we are really, really, really happy with our new staff, and they are happy.
Say that part again, sir.
Say it loud.
Say it louder.
Say it louder. Most of them are certified, and we are really happy to have them in our building.
Let's clap for that one.
Oh, yeah. Certified math teacher. And they've really, really not only just integrated into our building, but they have so much to bring and so much to offer. So already they're jumping up saying, hey, let's do this, let's do this. And some of them are the first ones in the building, the last ones to leave. So we are thrilled with Dr. Pless's department, with our amazing managers.
All right, so moving forward, one of the initiatives we decided, we wanted to reach out as far as we possibly could and bring exposure, opportunities, and access for our students, where opportunities that they've never experienced before, and things that the district just wasn't necessarily a focus on the middle school. So as you see, we partnered with STEM Forge Academy, and basically that's our e-game. So we have game design as well as game e-sports for all of our students. They're coming in our after-school program. They're willing to come in 4 days a week. We were only asking for two, but they're coming in 4 days a week, and the students are also hyped, as well as the young ladies. Because when we started talking about computers, we started talking about game design, and then we started talking about the application of how they can then transform that into jobs, into possible careers. So many of the students now are totally excited about what we're offering. And as I said, this is a new beginning. This is a new Toby. And another thing we're doing is Glenn Ford Waterborne Project. And I will say this too, through the hard work of, he's hiding behind the screen, but Dr. Sutton, this has been one of his pet projects. He's ensured that we were able to reach out to these and reach out to community members, build partnerships with organizations, and they kind of have adopted Toby as well. And hopefully down the line, we'll be able to say we received generous gifts as well. So Glenn Ford is a Waterborne Project, but basically teaches our students problem-solving skills, critical thinking. They're going to actually come to the classroom, and they're going to actually build boats inside the classroom.
Okay.
They will design them, they will paint them, they will do everything that they need to do, and then they will come back in the spring, take the boats, put them on the trailer, take them out to the water, and all of our students who basically put it together and assisted in the production, they then get to get in the boats, hopefully with life jackets, they put them on the water, and they learn how to, they actually want to row, utilize rowing boats and actually enjoy the project. And then another thing that we're proud of is our Girls on the Run. We are actually a new school, we're a site now for them, so in the springtime they will be coming, working out with our young ladies, teaching them collaboration, socialization, mentoring. They're providing many different skills that some of our young ladies need. And we didn't want to just always focus on the young men. We see that there's a need all the way across the board. And so we're happy with a lot of these new organizations that are coming in and now part of our Toby Nation. And now they're also part of Chester Upland School District. Because I know for sure that they are now talking about not only working for Toby, but moving into all the schools in the district if that's a possibility, if it's available. All right? Next. Oh, so looking forward to Math 24. I don't see. Dr. Sutton's still back there. And also Ms. Parker. I know a lot of the games and a lot of the student-focused activities, educational activities, Math 24, Reading Olympics. As you see, we are actually working on our Toby TV. So the presentation you've seen tonight, as she said, was on iPads, was on cell phones, and we're working to actually transform one of our classrooms, and we're actually trying to make it into a production studio for our students. We have a teacher named Mr. Johnson, who's multimedia, and he's awesome. And so I employ all of you to get an opportunity to come to Toby. Please come out and just kind of see some of the fun things that we're doing. As well, next week we start our elections for our student government. And I know Dr. Parkinson and his team, they came in and they met with the candidates, and we kind of did our election. And that's kind of in stride with what we do for our student government, also for voting for November. I see Ms. Arnold there. I know she'll be in our school working with our student governments, because what we then do is have them, they create videos, they then take the word out to the street to talk to their mothers, grandmothers, uncles, aunts about the importance of voting. And one of the things they say is, please vote because I can't. And that's kind of how they go into the direction as far as trying to recruit and bring parents in and making sure that they're voting. And of course, I'm sure everybody knows about the Buddha coding program that we have now in the district. Our social studies teachers will now actually be focusing on part of their curriculum, but also giving our students that exposure and that opportunity to work with CODI. That's the CODI program. All right?
Sure. One of the things that Mr. Proctor and I kind of had as a goal this year was really making sure that we were engaging all of our students and recognizing them all, making sure that everyone knew that they were also included. So we kind of touched base with one of our teacher's assistants about Spanish Cultural Month, Heritage Month, and also moving forward, making sure that our Spanish-speaking students really feel like they have a place at Toby Farms. In the ESL classroom, it is like its own little community, and it's wonderful, and it is welcoming, but we want to bring that out. There, you know, we want to make sure everyone feels included. So they worked in their classroom this week on the Dia de los Muertos, which is in October, and talking about the different holidays that they want to celebrate throughout the year in our building. So that's now in our lobby, and the students designed and put that all together, and above it is an explanation of the holiday that the students put together to share with the rest of the school. So that was really important to us this year. And again, students are always learning at Toby Farms, every classroom, every day, and they're really having a good time. All right, here's one more video that our students put together.
I'll give you this gift as well, and I'm sure the audience would appreciate the update, but we are moving forward with our ESSER projects, and today had a great meeting. So Toby Farms, we will be ordering, the way the schedule works now, it looks like all of the equipment will be ordered by December the 2nd. The bid process then starts. Hopefully having them awarded by mid-January so that we can get your new windows and HVAC system off and kicking. So we're moving. Don't tell Main Street. All right. We will now move on to our student reps. I'm so excited to have two student reps here. Z from Chester High School. And I apologize, I did not meet our STEM student rep yet.
Mariam.
I said it right. Because I mess up names a lot. So we want to start with Zeke. Z's the boss.
Okay. Which I'll
let you do. Do you want me to go from your right? You see the microphone is working.
So I did have a presentation.
Did you send the presentation?
Yeah, I sent it to Bill. I don't know if he sent it.
No one's received
Mr.
it.
Bell.
Okay, that's fine.
We'll make sure we have it next week. Next month. We'll have it next month.
So, September 15th was back to school night, and it was a success, if I do say so myself. Over 150 students and families attended who were met with the open arms of our school. Families were able to tour the school with their student schedules and meet their teachers. There were also presentations from Mr. Bell explaining what the students have been through so far. DCCS students were also able to present with their experience attending the program, and I also had a part in introducing our new families into the school's district with a speech welcoming everyone into our school year. So we did have guests as well, including the Boys and Girls Club of Chester, the Delaware County Technical School, Chester Community Coalition, U.S. Army, and more. Overall, I think everybody did what everybody was supposed to do, and everything was smooth. So we did have a new program introduced to the school called STEM TV. The first episode was aired on Tuesday, September 20th. I was able to talk with some of the production crew who were very excited about what's next to come in their program. Zion Lawrence, one of STEM TV's own anchors, thought the experience was amazing. He said he would highly recommend the newly formed program to other students. And of course, a big thanks to Ms. Myrtle and T3 Media who made all of this happen. So we held a student election for a new vice president of our senior year because Sally, my previous VP, Naomi Diaz, she moved to Puerto Rico during the summer. So a couple students ran for the position and had the chance to speak in front of the senior class. And with that, I want to formally congratulate Malachi Jackson, who blew us away with his speech. So we did also have an opportunity where we got to apply, me, another student named Kalita Ahmad, and Elizabeth Lasende, where we applied to a program with the Congressional Youth Cabinet with this U.S. Congress representative, Mary Gay Stanley. So we wrote essays, and we got to, when we wrote the essay, we sent it to the lady, and the lady sent us back an email, and we all got accepted. So the students chosen will provide her with the voice and perspective of the youth in our communities. And as one of the students accepted, I am very excited to be a part of this, and I'm very thankful for this opportunity. And our first meeting will be held this Sunday on October 2nd. Okay.
I just really want to first start by saying that I'm glad to see the growth that Chester High has had with their students and also their staff. And I'm going to say that we've brought similar programs as STEM with our Clippers TV that we have that I am a primary anchor on. And I'm going to say that we love the new programs that are being offered through our CTE, like I'm going to say the Clippers Cafe, where our culinary, cosmetology, they're probably going to open up and a lot of kids come down, get their hair done, their nails done, hair, things like that. Also, we just love the new uniforms and that y'all have provided for us, and definitely with, definitely we love our uniforms. We see like a lot of kids willing to come, eager to come to school. They feel better about coming to Chester High. And I'm gonna definitely say their mindset, their outlook upon this school has definitely changed. Let's ride in the hallway, respectful with the teachers, doing their work, and really engaged. And I'm just glad to really see that. Also with my peers, we posted our student council elections. That I am running for president for. Hopefully, I've received the news that I'm going tomorrow. That's good, and I'm gonna say it's one thing. Oh, yes, also, I was definitely saying the people that Chester Upland School District has brought to Chester High, they have brought a lot of things to the table, and I'm gonna say that's with support with our kids, opening up things like our SEL programs to help students definitely learn about their emotions so we can resort to less violence in our children and fights, and they can understand how to deal with these situations, especially with coming from the outside, that things might carry over into our school buildings, which has, I'm gonna say, made us go down, but we're starting to replenish and rebuild back up, not only with our schools, but in our community as well. So a lot of less gang activity and things as well that are coming just from going to school and having a good day. And I really like that for them. And another thing that is really good for us from Chester High, I would say, is definitely we're talking about getting more engaged with them at our town hall meetings, giving the kids a chance to voice their opinions and for them to show that they're listening. We have really, like I said, we've seen real good change, and we're hoping to bring more to the table with that, to give the kids better opportunities for them to go out and learn things from school that they can use in the real world for them. So it's not just about coming in school learning about 12 times primary to square, you know what I'm saying? They're learning how to maneuver in the real world, how to handle real life situations, and we're giving them the opportunities to step up and show their talents and their creativity. And so that's why I'm going to say Chester High has been very good. I'm very thankful that I'm attending and I get to experience this. So that's what y'all have. That's my advice.
All right. I think it's moving will now move to the section of the agenda where we are, or I will be approving the minute of the previous meeting on August 25th, 2022. So the meetings are hereby approved for the previous meeting of August 25th, 2022. Before we move into the final comment on action item only section, I have my updates as it pertains to ESSER. I do, wanted to give Mr. Pop before they skated out the other thing that we're going to be doing, so everyone knows. I know we talked about a lot of capital projects that are going to be happening. So we met again today. The restrooms throughout the district will most certainly be completed by the holiday, the Christmas holiday break. So you can let everybody know, Z, that we're coming around and we're renovating every bathroom. So that's going to be happening very, very soon, and everything will be completed again by the holiday break in December. At this time, if anyone has any public comment on action items only, please step to the microphone, state your name and address for the record. I don't have a list. I apologize. Second month in a row. It's not your fault, Dr. Fletcher. There are four audience members, so if you have...
Are you only doing education?
No, any action item agenda.
Oh, no, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Good evening, Denise Mosley, parcel ID 49-1101-04600. I have a few questions. First question is for agenda item A5. I know you can't get into specific details, but is that, can we at least know if this covers a period of time or is this just for one school year?
If I may, and with great respect, and because we must respect FERPA and the rights of students, if I'm reading the correct agenda item, my advice to the board and to the receiver would be not to comment in any way that might identify this particular student. So I will respectfully suggest to the receiver that question not be answered.
Okay, I'm not asking anything about the student. I'm concerned with the dollar amount. Is that affecting more than one year's budget?
I appreciate that. My advice is gonna be the same.
Okay, thank you. That's new. My second question was actually ESSER questions. You did clarify Toby Farms. But I did have questions about CUSA, the chiller, the window replacement, as well as STEM, the air handlers, and the cooling towers. Is that the same timeline for that, or will each school have its own timeline?
So Toby Farms, Main Street are on the same timeline. CUSA, as we had discussed, the windows and the chiller are part of the ESSER project. And then we talked about us doing more in CUSA. So CUSA is going to be two-part. We have two different engineers that are working on something. They'll be meeting next week so that they can coordinate efforts so we can get a timeline exactly for when everything will start at CUSA. Because we want to make sure, one, we're not duplicating services with the engineers. I'll have a timeline after we meet next week with the two engineers, Ms. Moore.
Okay, and that's just for CUSA. Okay.
Yes, and in STEM, I have to go back and look at my notes, and I can get back with you on that because I don't know if that was a part of that timeline or not.
No, it wasn't.
Yes, STEM wasn't a part of this timeline, so gotcha. I'll get you an updated one on that as well.
Okay, and again, we're only given 3 minutes, but you're asking me to ask all questions on the agenda. So, I mean, I have questions about...
The Sunshine Law requires that you ask questions on the agenda items before we take action, so...
Okay. No, but I was just saying, if you... Usually we go by sections.
Gotcha.
So...
No, we can keep it going.
All right, as long as I'm not cut off. I also, a few meetings back, I had asked about position and creating FTEs, and I was told by Dr. Pless that the restructuring only was creating one FTE, but when I was on the website and then I saw a position being added for a supervisor of academics on posted, as well as a guidance counselor secretary. So I am questioning those positions as part of the personnel. I don't know if we can speak to that tonight, but.
What agenda item are you referring to? Because right now we're on agenda items only.
Oh, okay, well, I'll bring that to non-agenda items.
Okay.
Okay, yeah, my other two questions, I'll put them under number.
Okay, thank you. Are there any other public comment on agenda items only?
Thank you so very much. My name is Jean Arnold, and I reside at 2601 McCary Street. My agenda item comments, they're a little mixed up. One is for the ESSER agenda items. You have D4, where you are purchasing flute phones for Coosa Main Street and Scepter, and there's another place in the agenda where you're doing a similar thing for the Edmond School. And my comment for that is, thank you. I am very much excited in my looking forward to the flute phones. I don't know why I have such an affinity for that particular musical device, but I've been waiting for that, and I thank you so very much for putting those orders through for those schools. There's an item that you have in here about a safety officer. And my question and concern is, have we begun to do strategic plans for drills for an active shooter? It's not necessarily the safety officer per se, but because the safety issue is an agenda item of sorts. But my concern is that we have a very comprehensive plan and start to execute those drills. I can remember some months ago that was brought up here, but I don't think we've ever done any follow-up on those drills. So I just wanted to put that out there for tonight.
Right. The drill, Ms. Arnold, we are coordinating that with law enforcement as we speak. Dr. Parks and I had a meeting with the commissioner and county law officials just this week. So it's in the works, and the school district has had knowledge training
and active shooter training for the drills. So schools have already started participating in active shooter drills where they're shelter in place. So that has taken place. So our next big piece is having law enforcement come in through the building. So all the buildings are well underway. We're creating their crisis response plans. They have identified the crisis response teams. It's moving forward.
Great. And I think we probably have something in here about hiring teachers or some persons. I don't know exactly where it is, but my question has to do with vacancies, I think, and maybe some of the other schools. I'm so glad that Toby has filled so many of those positions, especially for math and so on. But my question is, particularly for the high school, I'm getting some indication that there are probably still some vacancies there for teachers, and their class sizes might be a bit larger than maybe some of the other schools. I know we have a teacher shortage across America, and I know we have done some things to retain teachers and to hire.
I'm not the actual opposite, specific to the agenda item.
I thought we had an agenda item, and if not, I'll be simply repeating.
Okay, B1.
I'm trying to link it to something so that
B1, we're hiring
yes
a teacher's assistant at Edmond College Academy, a health and PE teacher at Stetson, fifth and sixth grade math teacher at Edmond College Academy.
Yes, and so my concern about the hiring is, are there some other needs that we have not yet talked about? What have you? I'm concerned about some other vacancies with education in our district, and as it's wondering if you could speak to that tonight.
I probably will say I will speak to that when we do the general public comment section.
Okay, thank you.
Mm-hmm. Any additional public comment on action items only? Okay, so I'm going to do something a little different that we're not used to.
And that is, I commend the cabinet members and the school board members on last week at your committee as a whole meeting. I don't attend purposely at your meeting, but I do watch. And I believe we went through all of the agenda items, and those agenda items, you all had a good opportunity to have some deliberation, ask questions. Cabinet was able to explain in great detail what everything was. So, Mr. Donatelli, you tell me if I'm wrong. For us not to be redundant, I don't know if we need to have cabinet members come back up. If we have agendas out for the public, it's on the board for us to kind of read back through all of the action items. But we will, again, offer an opportunity for public comment on and to clarify and answer any questions that they may have on any agenda. So what I want to do, Mr. Donatelli, is just go ahead and approve action items of each section without the cabinet member coming back up.
That's fine.
That's legal and fine?
It's legal and fine.
All right. Again, not that it's Thursday night football or anything. I'm not doing it because of that. Ms. Bev said that in the room back there. But at this point in time, I would like to approve action items under the education agenda, A1 through A. A1 through A27. So action items are hereby approved for the education agenda for A1 through A27. A28 is actually saying that approval of the agenda items. All right. So on the personnel agenda, at this point, I would like to hereby approve action items B1 through B3. Action items B1 through B3 are hereby approved. Business agenda. At this time, I hereby approve business agenda item C1 through C10. C1 through C10 are hereby approved. Under the ESSER agenda, at this time, I hereby approve action item B1 through B13. D14. Action item B1 through D14 are hereby approved. And at this time, we will have public comment for general public comments. If you have a public comment, please state your name and address for the record. Step to the microphone. Oh, we have the list. I'm sorry. And again, I know that we said that we wanted to get in a group of things and do things, and the deliberative meeting or the committee as a whole meeting is a way for us to do what we did last week. And I think last week went extremely well with the board and cabinet members. And we will always have an opportunity for the public to ask questions at the top of the meeting on any agenda item before it is voted on. But this time, Mr. Nee Mosley, parcel ID 49110104600.
Thank you very much. I also will publicly like to say last week's meeting was very well done. The two questions that I have were about FTEs that we stated we were adding one FTE when we were doing restructuring. However, I do see that there is a supervisor of academic position that's currently posted on our website or the school's website, as well as a guidance counselor secretary. The supervisor of academics, when I read that, it kind of like those functions will fall under a Dr. Mumin, a Dr. Sutton, or even possibly Sarah Ferguson. So I was wondering, what was the purpose of that particular position, as well as the guidance counselor secretary. When I read that job description, It sounds like this is what the guidance counselors should be doing, so I'm not understanding why the guidance counselors need a secretary. And then the third, last week, Dr. Parkinson mentioned hiring a special position to create, to help with capital projects, but I didn't see that position listed in this week's agenda. I don't know if plans change for that or if that position.
So that position is coming. Again, we will be using our ESSER dollars to do project management for that particular position, getting everything together to make sure that we're compliant before it's posted. That much. I'm embarrassed to say I don't know anything about the second guidance counselor. I don't look at the job postings. I'll say that first. I need to defer to Dr. Putz on that.
Please defer to me on the guidance secretary, if you don't mind. I would say, Ms. Rosen, please, you know, thank you so much for asking those questions. I think we would be hard-pressed to go to any school in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania high school that does not have a guidance secretary. It's obviously a needed position for the amount of work that the position entails. What we want our guidance counselors to do is to be able to sit, meet with students, hold groups with our students, interact with our students, counsel them, focus on college scholarships, post-secondary opportunities. A lot of the clerical work, things that need to be taken care of, that our school counselors are handling is something that normally a guidance secretary would do in any school. I can be honest with you, upon my arrival, I was quite shocked that there wasn't a guidance secretary, and we're actually asking for a guidance secretary to be shared between STEM and Chester High School. If I had it my way, we have a guidance secretary in both schools, which is, again, I think in any school that you go to, in Commonwealth High School, there's a guidance secretary position. So I was really surprised that we didn't have one here. So it's a position I think is extremely needed. I can assure you that it's going to help the efficiency with the school council being able to serve our students better. And again, I'm surprised that we didn't have one. And I was told that there was one years ago, and we hear those things, and that for some whatever reason, they were no longer here when they started making cuts. They cut the guidance secretary, but I would say personally, that would be one of the last positions I would cut.
Does the FTE that got added?
I think there was some.
So the restructure that we talked about in July was great. Guidance counselor. So the monies that are allocated in the budget, they're line items, buildings, or like administration. So the monies are just moved around to address the positions that are actually needed. So it's not that it didn't exist, it's just the way we reallocated it. But the comment that I made was specific to administration, not to the entire school district. So we added a lot of positions, but we just changed like the names. Like if we didn't need a math teacher because these kids merged out, then we changed it over to a science teacher position need. So that has happened throughout. But the money that is allocated in the budget, the positions have not exceeded.
And can you also speak to the supervisor of academics?
So the supervisor of academics position will similarly model what Dr. Parker's position is, but again, the monies were in the budget. They were just reallocated to positions that we deemed as necessary and replaced positions that we did not think.
And also, I still can't locate the organizational chart that would probably help me with some of these types of questions.
It's under HR, but go ahead, Dr. Plus, you can, but it is there.
On the website?
Yes, ma'am.
It's not under HR. It's under the, there's a home section, and then that very next one is like about our district. It's all the way at the bottom. It says organizational chart.
And the safety plan as well. I could not locate that.
The
health and safety plan that was referenced last week.
It should be under that our district tab. I know that Dr. Sutton and I did meet with Ms. Murta creating it, so she was charged with adding that information to the website, and she did confirm it was there, so I would check under the our district tab slide or the one that says for staff.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
Thank you. And it's all updated. I sent that out a few weeks ago from Dr. King. We have met and updated the entire plan with the new CDC requirements and guidelines, so it's up to date.
All right, thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, Ms. Baldwin.
Thank you.
And we'll
will discuss personnel changes in the format that I would like to see moving forward, because I never want to sit here and not be able to know and what's going on with us, the allocated dollars that we're receiving. We'll discuss that later. We have Ms. A.G. Narno.
Thank you for letting us know that that chart is there. Some of us were looking for it. We didn't find it, so thank you so very much. I would ask, too, because we make so many changes in administration, that we are able to keep it up to date so that we'll know who's in which position. And please, if we can, have accurate phone numbers that we can use to get in touch with those persons who are on the chart. That would be helpful. I have a question or concern that we make the agenda available a week early from tonight, because when I looked for the agenda when the elected school board was having its committee meetings, I wasn't able to find it. And so I was silent because I hadn't been prepared and done my homework for that meeting. And so I had no questions that night. I did find the agenda. I think it was yesterday. I had a cadre of folks looking for it. So I'm very grateful for that. But what I'm asking for is that we think about making the agenda available earlier so that the community would have an ability to produce it and what have you, and give some comments, be more active, with the school district, et cetera.
And Ms. Hunter, that was my understanding, that when the board gets their agenda, that it should be draft form public.
Thank you, sir. I heard that there's a phone policy over at one of the schools, at least, and the children are not having the phones in the classroom. I think I heard that at one of the back to school nights. And I think that is absolutely wonderful. I expect for you to get some pushback on that, but I'm saying please hold fast and consider having that policy across the board, because I think all the teachers and educators can benefit without the distraction in the classrooms from cell phones. So I think that's a really solid policy that you all have implemented, at least in one building. Strategies for student achievement. I'm asking if we can grant and publish a strategy. That's why I'm wearing my blue ribbons, you know I'm adamant about that. What I haven't seen is a very comprehensive plan to move our test scores towards the area of blue. And I'm asking that we give that some serious thought. I don't know if we have or not. I just haven't heard about it and I haven't seen those plans. So I'm asking if we really, really make that a key priority item, because I do not want our school district to consistently be at the bottom of the ranking when we look at academic performance for the Commonwealth. And I know, totally am convinced that with a very good plan, we can show tremendous closure on those academic gaps. And so I'm asking that you all work on that. Don't know if you're not, but I would like to see a very comprehensive plan for closing those academic gaps. And I think, the agenda. We used to have a condensed board summary report of expenses, and I don't see that anymore. It was very thick piece of information where we could see expenditures and what have you, and I haven't seen that for a while published. And I'm thinking and hoping that we could possibly do that as a part of what we publish.
We do publish it, Ms. Arnold. When you go on the website to get the agenda, the attachments are there, you have to click to open them up. We don't print them anymore.
No, I'm not asking necessarily to print them. I was just trying to find my way to find them.
When you go on to Board Docs to get the agenda, you can click the tabs under the section, those agenda items. There'll be a little link in it to open those documents up for you.
Okay, thank you so much. I think that pretty much covers items that I have on my list. So thank you so very much.
Thank you. Tony Alexander, 2403 West 4th Street.
Good evening.
Good evening.
I am the parent of Tania. My daughter left Catholic school to start at seventh grade. She's been an honor roll student all the way up until 10th. Suffers with, she has a 504 plan to her anxiety. She had an anxiety attack a couple weeks ago in school. And her anxiety got her to outbursts where she cussed out the vice principal. She should have been suspended. That's what she should have. Maybe more than one day, but they gave her one day. My daughter is in a sorority, top of her class. She works, she don't get into no trouble. Not only did they suspend her, when I brought her back, they put her on probation. My daughter has never been in trouble. To put my daughter on probation is a slap in the face. I'm a probation officer. I've been a PO for 23 years. I've seen some of the worst kids ever not be put on probation. I came back here. She's in the DCTS program. She did the summer program for the medical foreclosure. She was in your program. She didn't even know she was removed. She went and they told her she was removed. I came over here last week and spoke to Dr. Ramin. I got a call from you. I was in court with a client. I reached out to her and to you three times. Nobody has never responded back. You guys say y'all here for these kids. I'm a parent, and what they're doing to my daughter is wrong. She doesn't even want to go to school anymore. She's walking on eggshells. So something has to be done. Either they're going to pick and choose what kids they pick with. I see stuff all the time. But my daughter, who's been a straight-A student, they now put her on probation until January. And according to the law, 504 plan, she should have never been suspended in the first place. Not only did they suspend her, now she's on probation. So we don't get it situated. I have letters in my here from her doctors. I have been in contact with the educational law. She should have never been suspended. She has a 504 plan with Tammy Coffey. She's phenomenal. But some stuff is going on that you guys, not you guys, but they're overlooking over there. So all I'm asking is that she be treated fairly. Now my daughter walking on, she's a cheerleader. She's now been suspended from cheer. She hasn't cheered in three games because they don't want to kick her off because they were like, this is not a kid who ever gets in trouble. And I need to come over here to a meeting in order to speak to you directly or speak to her. And all I want is my daughter to be treated fairly or for us to get a phone call. I never even received a call back, not an email, not a call back from you or you.
Let me just say, Dr. Ramin gave me a message. Called you, and we can talk about this after. You know, and I know your daughter. I know your daughter well. Mm-hmm. So all we did this is definitely something she's offline. But I did reach out to her.
I wanted to be online because I want people to know that kids with disabilities shouldn't be affected.
I'm talking about speaking specifics to your daughter. I want to speak to you about your daughter, but I'm not going to do that openly.
Okay. Are you really going to? Because I emailed you a couple times and haven't got a response. So.
We'll speak about it after the meeting. I tell you, I didn't receive an email.
Okay.
I did not receive it.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Anthony. We apologize for that, but we'll get right on it this evening. There are no more people on the sign in sheet for public comment. I see a parent I know who have reached out to me and said they were making a public comment, but I guess he's not one of them.
I don't know.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So this part of the meeting, you can ask any question. Correct.
My name is Shaquille Harper, address 2 University. My questions are, I'm more of athletic mom, so I'm like the basketball. My son is Kyrie Womack. He currently attends STEM, loves them, loves Principal Bell, all four of other when she's going with the program. But my concern is with what's being done with our program. As you can see, they are revamping the football program. Kyrie is with the basketball program, and I'm having some concerns. I'm reaching out to the coaches. I'm not getting the answers that I want. on the academic end, and I'm on the athletic end. My son, athletic-wise, great. Academic-wise, great. But I don't know if you guys are aware, we are losing a lot of our kids to the other schools, Catholic schools, rather. Because parents feel like their kids are not going to get what they need here, academic-wise and athletic-wise. Academic-wise, I'm not in agreement with that. Only FPM, I don't know what goes on at Chester High School or any other school. And I can honestly say that, but as of now, I plan on being more involved, volunteering more. Because of what I am seeing going on, academic-wise, I love seeing STEM. And I have talked to a number of parents of, like, basically coaching them to, like, come on. Like, I know I want to transition with our school. We need to do better. We can do better. And I see the change coming. And I love the change that is being in place for these kids. But because we are losing our kids, because parents are not happy with what's going on that end, and not just the football program needs to be revamped. All of our programs need to be revamped. We need fresher faces, fresher minds with these programs to go along with the kids and the times that are changing. And I'm saying this today because I'm reaching out and I'm not getting what I need in response for my son. One thing about me, I'm a mom that moves out. And usually I ruffle feathers because I'm that mom that moves out. Not because I want to be that. I'm not trying to be rough or anything, but I'm that mom that moves out and I'm going to do what I need to do for my child. So if I see that no changes are being made, now my son did leave. He went up to Roman Catholic because it was offered to him. And me being a mom, I'm going to do what I need to do for my son. So I felt like, okay, we make a change, make a move. He went up there, academic-wise, it wasn't happening. They were like, oh, you had this already? You had this? They going down, they're sitting there with their mouths open because my son had all AP classes. So when we got up there, he was above them. So they put him in their advanced class. But those schools are not doing what they need to do either. And those people are paying out of pocket. So we came back. But nobody is pushing for my son on me on the academic end and on the athletic end. Nobody's pushing for my son to go to the next level. And that's where we're losing kids because these other schools are offering, but we're not. We're not reaching out to college coaches. We're not putting our kids on the map. There's no, I know it's resources out there, but we're not using them. And as a mom, I'm going to do what I need to do for mine, but I just want them backing on me. I just want backing on it. And so I don't know who I need to speak to get the proper backing. But I did reach out to get AD last night. And the response that he gave me, I felt like wasn't suitable. So I don't know if it's because you got too much going on as a football coach. So as the AD is not being handled over here. But to my knowledge, you were under all programs. And I made him aware that I was going to speak on it because I came to you. And I reached out to you, and you didn't want nothing to do with it. I'm serious on that, and not just for my son. I'm not just here for my son. And I'm speaking for other people, but you know, not everybody's going to speak up. But I'm that mom that will. I'm sorry. Don't want to see me alive. Don't want to get tired of me. I'm telling you now. You are, until I see the change that needs to be made. You are, and even after my son leaves, I'm still here for other kids. I don't just say my son. I have a lot of sons. So if you see me and I'm like, that's my son, but that's my son too. That's my daughter too. All these kids are ours. We're a village, right? And I'm speaking up for the village. Our kids need help. They need support in everything. Whatever athletic program it is, I don't care. They just need the backing. I love that these kids are going to school on academic scholarship too, but we have athletic kids that don't get the offer they need because they don't have the backing. And when I said these kids are going to these other schools, because these other schools are putting these kids in positions with these colleges. They're reaching out. They're doing what they need to do to make sure they get. I'm not just talking about us going to put the parent. I'm not just talking about this. I'm talking about it's other schools out there, but no one is reaching out to these schools and putting these kids in positions.
All right. Thank you for coming
and
bringing that up. Couple things that I've heard. Glad you brought your son back to the day. Obviously.
also heard you said that you want to volunteer.
I sure will.
Love that as well. That would be more come back to that stuff, man. I think with Dr. Parkinson, Dr. Sutton, and Coach Bells, and the all-press support, because it does take the best thing in our boards as well. Support to for the every student. For the and increase our enrollment here. So that's key. So if you don't mind after the meeting, getting some time.
Are you going to comment at all about teacher shortages or hiring and that kind of thing?
Oh, so Ms. Arnold, I'll say this, and I always say, you hear me say this all the time, doesn't tell me when to shut up. And probably Dr. Press as well. There, we have.
That was the key.
Because I don't contract. We have some people who have some contractual obligations that were hired here, and they had to fulfill those contractual obligations. Other 60-day notice, so they are coming. They just had to fulfill their obligation with their. They weren't released from their prior school district. But they were hired with us, so we should get an influx of the team coming in a very, very new. If there is nothing else,
So if you go, you know how to get to the organizational chart, yeah?
Yes,
okay.
Under our district, last one.
That's the organizational chart there. It's online. Yeah. The second document that you were asked. I will admit it took me a moment to find it, but yeah. Go down to handbooks. No. The health and safety plan is right there. And it's under handbook. I guess, and for all intents and purposes, that document would exist.
Thank you, Ms. We have three boxes. Those three, to whom do they report? In the column next to that, to whom do they report?
This amount of should be
connected. Use the column. So, the question is, are we going to make that change there?
The lines aren't there, but usually operation.
And if you access it on a mobile device, you will see the lines there.
Yeah,
it does show up as a PDF with the lines there. So it could just be something with this particular view, but it does show up with the lines.
Hard copy that I was given way back some months ago looked the same way. Mr. Wilson, can you grab that? And I believe.
So Dr. Lopez, Dr. Sutton,
no.
And Dr.
And we is over Lonely and Hurt.
So HR is a is neutral. There's no line. It's directly to Dr. Parkinson. Dr. Sutton has academics, which people will call academics. And then Dr. Moline has operations. So this is the org chart that we made. Our public org chart. The one from the same org chart. The titles underneath and stuff was not all the way filled in, so it's more expanded. It just was like
so we will work on getting it in a better version there because everyone here is pulling up on their mobile device. It's the right. So we'll work with our IT folks to get it done right on the way. All right, if there is no other comment from board members, you need to adjourn.
Very good.
Yes, you guys are very good.